They are progressing, but they will not want to leave Macau with three straight defeats. As for Thailand, it's an interesting blend of youth and experience. You can see the likes of Chatchuon Moxery, number 19, a teenager, playing alongside the 35-year-old Bloomjit Tinkao. Opposite ends of the age spectrum, but it's very much working effectively for a Thailand team that is just getting better and better. As I say, they've already equaled their tally of wins from last year's VNL. They had a creditable effort in the World Championship after the VNL last year, and then they picked up a silver medal in the Asian Games to cap off a very good 2018. Well, the key players for Belgium include Kaja Grabelna, the Polish-born hitter, one of the very, very few players that managed to get anything out of that formidable Chinese defense yesterday. The Chinese, the stunning defensive and blocking team, very, very hard to penetrate their defenses. But Grabelna did it to good effect yesterday, 14 points in what proved to be a losing effort. And a very, very capable player on her day. We'll be looking to make some inroads into Thailand's defenses, and certainly Marlies Jensens will be looking to make some inroads as well. A middle blocker who is also a deadly server. You don't often put those two together, but Jensens came up with five aces yesterday against China, and that was no fluke. She has over 10 aces through five matches in the VNL, 11 in total. So Thailand will have to be on their guard against her when she's up to serve. As for the Thais, let's have a look at some of their key players. And here's one of them right here, Bloomjit Tinkao, the veteran middle blocker. Very creative player, likes to spike on the move. The running attack is one of the features of her game. Very much a leader, not the captain of this team, but a definite leader as well. And she is one of those players that just keeps everything steady and calm when the heat is on. They've got three big, big hitters. And it was this woman here, Malika Kantong, who stood out yesterday in that gang of three that they've got. Decent server as well, very capable server. Watch out too for Chatchuon Moxery and Ajcharapong Kongyot. That's the big three for Thailand. Well, the Belgians wouldn't have expected to get anything out of China. As we look at our two referees, chair referee from Hong Kong, Hyun Fai Lee. And nearest to us on the floor from Japan, Sumie Mioi.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the Green Team National Anthem. 请大家起来. The first National Anthem of Belgium, 叫比利时国歌. And the national anthem of Thailand, Chao Thai Go Go Go. Thank you.
Well, there's the colourful Thai cheerleader who has been very loud, very proud of his nation over the last 3 days. He's in the house, of course. Well, for Belgium, I'm sure the message will be just go out and win that first set. Stop playing catch-up. As for Thailand, a chance to balance out their VNL record at 3 wins and 3 defeats. A chance to win back-to-back VNL matches for the first time in the young history of the competition. And an opportunity to continue to grow and develop. The goal for Thailand is to qualify for the Olympic Games for the first time ever. There's the small matter of the VNL first, World Cup later in this crowded year as well. Some Olympic qualifiers coming up. And Thailand will be hoping to come to the boil at the right time. And Belgium will certainly be looking to bounce back. No one more so than the player that's just been introduced, Britt Herpots, number 3. Celine Van Gestel, number 7. Coming out there, Kaya Grabelna. We've already talked about her. You know, the importance that she brings for this Belgium team. Marlies Janssens, Gert van der Broek, the experienced head coach, has decided not to make any changes. It looks like exactly the same starting line of Ilka van der Viva, as we've seen not only in the first two matches in Macau, but also the 3 that he sent out in Ruza, Bulgaria as well. There is one change, though. Silke van Avermaet comes in for Dominika Sobolska, but those two tend to share playing time as well. Jody Guillams will get the start at libero. Expect to see Anna Valkenborg, the other libero, as well for Gert van der Broek, this very experienced, a very capable coach who's been in charge of the Belgian national women's team for more than a decade. Well, the starting lineup for Thailand features Phumjit Dinkao, Nutsara Tongkom, of course, the setter, and the skipper, Malika Kantong, who had such a big, big day yesterday in that 4-set win, aided and abetted by the other two members of the Gang of Three. There's one of them, there's Charapon Kongyok going through. And the third member getting introduced now, Chatchu On Moxri, the youngster. And another youngster, the 18-year-old middle blocker, Tisha Korn Boonlert, with Pirat Panoy getting the start at libero. Supatra Peroj, the other libero, will also expect to see some playing time for coach Danai Sriwacharajatakul, known to everybody in the business as coach Danai, for obvious reasons. He's done a very good job with this Thai squad. There's one of their big hitters, the charismatic and exciting as Charapon Kongyot. On the other side, Ilka van der Viva, such a driving force, the captain and the setter of this Belgian squad. That is how they line up. Just the one starting change, Silke van Avermaet. And as for Thailand, no changes at all. Why would he change a winning formula? Everybody's healthy, so they go out again. So can Belgium finish what's been a disappointing trip to Macau with a win? Or will Thailand make it back-to-back wins and 3 out of 6 in the VNL? We're about to find out. It is, of course, best of 5 sets. First of 25 wins the set. You must win by 2 clear points. If it goes to a 5th set, the tiebreaker, it's a race to 15 points. But again, you must win by 2 clear points. Wouldn't be a total shock if this one went long. A lot depends on how Belgium start, and they've sent out their ace server, Marlies Janssens, right off the bat. Janssens with her first serve is a good one, but they are not able to capitalize, and they pay for that as Charapon Kongyot drives it deep. Now, service reception was not good there. Now, Belgium, though, unable to capitalize, and it's Kongyot with the first strike of this match. And a deep spike, very effective. Chatchu On Moxri now, one of 2 teenagers in this starting lineup, and a complete mess made by Celine Van Gestel. Van Gestel has had ups and downs in service reception. And obviously all these teams do their homework on each other. They look for what they think might be a weakness on service reception. And if they find a weakness, all these teams go straight after it. Van Gestel maybe on the receiving end again. No, or rather, yes, it was. She was done a much better job there, a very much better job. What a difference that makes. All about service reception. If that's good, everything else can flow and follow on from there. Ilka van de Viva. Great pickup there by Valkenborg. Solid backcourt defending as well from the Thais. Here comes the pipe attack, and it's too good from Chachu on Moxley. The attack hit is all about timing. She got this one perfectly. Great elevation. Nothing Celine Van Gestel could do backcourt to pick that one up. Now the Thais with the early advantage. And the 18-year-old Tisha Korn Boonlert, who has picked up some terrific experience over the course of this competition with serve, but it's sent back with interest by Kaya Grabelna. Nobody home backcourt for the Thais. Certainly not where Grabelna placed it. Now, Britt Herberts, it'll be very interesting to see what Britt is able to come up with. The Chinese neutralized her yesterday. Once again, popping up far side, this time as Chatterporn Konyot. Strong start from her. Swinging through with authority. The blockers were in place. They couldn't control the block. So she'll now go back and serve. Thailand's top scorer in the competition thus far comes in with 52 points and has very quickly added a couple more here. The pipe attack doesn't work from her, but didn't really manage to time that right. It's Guillaume's picking that up backside. Van Gestel goes cross court, denied by little Gulapa, the libero. They'll try again with Herberts. No, that's Gulapa again, scurrying around there. Now Malika denied by Guillaume's. What a rally. Terrific finish as well. Powerful cross court spike from the Belgians to end what really was the rally of the match so far. You get the sense that Kaya Grabelna means business today. Both teams, solid backcourt, both liberos, really impressive. But there was no stopping that one from Grabelna. Silke van Avermaet up next. She's not a bad server either. Wouldn't be a shock to see her conjure up an ace. It was a good one as well. Malika Canton, not ideal service reception, so it's just dump over and hope for the best. And Gestel conjures up a winner. Yeah, the Belgians back on level terms. Well, this all came off the poor service reception. That handed the initiative over to the Belgians. Ljubjit Tinkau got a fingertip to it, but no more than that. Van Gestel doing enough. So Van Avermaet will serve the net serve. You will see that at this level, because safe conservative serving doesn't get you anywhere. The opponents at this level, world-class level, will just smash safe stuff back. So you've got to go for it, got to be ambitious. That does mean you'll get net serves, you'll get long serves. Malika Canton always likes to send in a big serve like that one right there that comes straight back on first touch. Oh, Ljubjit denied by the block. Great work there from Van Gestel, far side. Van Gestel again with a terrific dig. Pipe attack comes through as Chatterporn denied. Great dive from Van de Viva, and Van Gestel, appropriately enough, finishes the job. Well, that was a big point for Celine Van Gestel. Two big defensive hits, then the angled spike to finish it off. Didn't have a rush of blood to the head. It was all about placing it there from Van Gestel. There was a big landing area available, and she took it. Another really good rally between these two teams. That's a terrific dig from Van de Viva. There's Van Gestel, not once but twice defensively, and then taking out the block, getting the angle absolutely right. Kaya Grabelna up next. Well, 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 they watched it thinking this is going to fly, and it didn't. The ace serve from Kaya Grabelna. Yeah, Belgium picking up a bit of early momentum here. Well, close, but not quite close enough for the Belgians. Oh, goodness me, they had the right idea, just couldn't keep it in play, and it just agonizingly drops the wrong side of the line off the Van de Viva block. Thailand needed that point. We're back on level terms again. Herbots. Now that is what Britt Herbots brings to the show. We barely saw it yesterday in China. That outstanding defensive work from the Chinese restricted Herbots to just 4 kills on 15 attempts. 4 points total for her. And when you consider that Britt Herbots came into this one averaging a lot more than that, that was really all about China and how good they are. Now, talking about good offense, what about that? From Ajkarapun Kongyot, all smiles off the back of this one. She's coming up with some big winners today. That's her 3rd kill point of this first set. Tom Kong with serve, they'll take it far side. Janssen's denied. The pipe attack will come in instead. That wasn't going to be stopped. No stopping Kaya Grabelna. Some of the big hitters are establishing themselves early here. So we get to the first technical timeout. The early skirmishing suggests we could have a really good match to look forward to here. Well, the Belgians won't know what to do with themselves if they win the first set. It's been nearly a year since that's happened at world level. And it's an encouraging start for a team that has been slow to get off the blocks throughout the VNL this season. Not today. Now, let's see if they can get a couple of points on serve from the always dangerous Marlies Janssens. One-handed set from Tomcott. They'll take it far side. Herbots comes up with another one. That's 2 for Britt Herbots, who came into the game against China yesterday averaging 17 points per game, but who was so restricted by that Chinese defense. Just 4 points on 15 spike attempts as well. She didn't play badly, but that was just what the Chinese defensively can do to you. Janssens goes for an ambitious one that is over-ambitious. Well, it's the Thais looking to level it up with a point on serve. They'll send it near side. Picked up nicely. The Van Avermaet spike taken away. And another opportunity for the Thais here. They'll come near side. Malika just enough. Spins it off the block. Van de Viva and Van Avermaet were there at the net. They couldn't get any control on it. And Malika Kantong with her first point of the match. Certainly won't be her last. And we haven't seen the last of Chatchon Moxery either. Here she is serving. Pipe attack. Oh, goodness me. Really went for the angles there and only just got it. Oh, I think Kaya Grabelna would have looked at that one in slow motion thinking, is it going to drop in? It only just did. That one didn't. Well, the Belgians really looking for the lines here. Now, is that going to catch any part of the line? Called out. but immediately challenged. And looking at that replay, the Belgians may well have a good case here. It only takes any part of the circumference of the ball to cover any part of the line to be ruled in. And that's surely got a chance. No, good call. Good call. Worth a challenge, though. That was close. Yeah, we're not stopping that. That was as easy as you like. And again, that is a classic example of what happens if it's a nice, safe, conservative serve. All the initiative goes to the receiving team. And if they execute, you probably can't defend it. Herberts with the big jump serve that skims the net as well, just to create a bit of chaos as Charapon can't get a winner. That is a brilliant dig in the backcourt from Moxrey. She's there again. And then Malika tries to go cross-court and misses. Big miss. After all that solid defensive work from the Thais as well. So Belgians, well, that's going to get a challenge as well. And it certainly can't be a ball in or out challenge, because that was clearly out. But did it touch a fingertip on the way through, is the question they're asking. Coaches are always relying on their players here. Somebody clearly saw something, or thought they saw something. And they're right. Silke van Avermaet's left middle finger. Good call. So that Belgian lead was short-lived. We're back on level terms here. There's Charapon Kongyot up next. Ooh, that's going to go. Oh, it came back first touch. What a clever serve. Oh, nicely finished. The Plumjit Tinkau signature running attack for the first time in the match. What a serve that was from Raj Chanaporn. It looked like it was going to go long, then suddenly it slammed the brakes on. And it came back on first touch. And if it comes back on first touch, that's what you've got to do with it. Clever serve. What's she going to do now? That's a mid-range one. Guillaume's keeps it in play. Grabelna can't beat the backcourt. Old Moxrey's there again now. An early whistle there that goes in favour of the Belgians. So we're level again. Van Avermaet. Nice. Well, Malika Kantong, all about the lines there. Called in, and the Belgians said, no, no, no. So what have they seen? Now, that looked like it caught the line, but their response immediately was, no, it did not. So they're going to call it. That seemed like a group decision as well. That wasn't one player. They all had a look, so they saw something. And they're right. Those far side challenges always have to go down to the players. The coaching staff, obviously, they don't have a good view of it. Nobody has a good view of it except the players. Van Avermaet serving Malika, the pipe attack has Charapon. Nice bit of defensive work from Van Gestel again. Pianut with the pickup, Tinkau with the running attack, denied by Van Gestel again. Well, that's Moxrey can just dump and hope, but the Belgians can mount an attack from all angles again, denied as Charapon this time. Malika goes deep, nothing doing. So they'll come over to Van Gestel as Charapon can't keep it in play. Celine Van Gestel again, very prominent in that rally. Another terrific rally, and we're getting treated to a lot of those in this match. And Van Gestel comes up with the decisive touch once again. Well, that was the one pick up in the backcourt from Herbots that helped keep the point alive. And despite the best efforts of the Thai rear guard, Celine Van Gestel eventually breaks through, which means Silke van Avermaet stays there, and the Thais now really need to get her out of there fast. They need a side out. Oof, good serve. Oh, what an important pickup that was from the bootstraps from Chechuan Boxery. Malika Canton swings through to get a big point for the Thais. Well, that was a very important pick up from Chachu on Moxri. Off a serve that just dipped and died. Thailand still chasing this one. Narrow gap. They just need 1 point to level it up. They're not going to get it there. Side out. Grabelna then with an aggressive one that just travels too far. Bloomjit Tinkau serves Van Gestel. Herbots, that's nice. So we get to the second technical timeout with Belgium with a slender lead to protect. Can they take a first set for the first time in nearly a year in the VNL? 16-14. Crying Grabelna was the main source of offense for them against China yesterday. She's leading the way today with an ace and four very authoritative strikes as well. There's a pipe attack. She is deadliest working the outside. There she is again, lining up, waiting for the reverse set. And when she goes cross-court off that reverse set, it's very, very hard to defend her. Here's Van Gestel. They had a very impressive first set. Not stopping that. Tisha Korn Boonlert off the quick set. That's another one that's tough to defend. You've got a middle blocker rising high off a quick set, taking that ball so high. The block on the other side of that just cannot form. Oh, did that travel? Yes, it did. They're asking in that huddle, Britt Herbert saying, did it get a touch? Well, the call on the court is that's long and no block touch, but the Belgians think that they saw a stray finger there. This is another important challenge as well. Well, anxious moments on both sides. I think they weren't absolutely emphatic, the Belgians, but it was a, oh, maybe it caught something. So they don't know. Sometimes they know, and you can tell in the body language. Here you can tell it's like, oh, we're not sure. So we're going to have a look. Well, what do we got? Anything? Nothing? There is a touch there. Another really good call. Just as Chatterpon Kongyot and her right hand getting out, one of the right fingernails getting the slightest of touches. So the Belgians keep noses in front here. And surely the time is right for Marlies Janssens to come up with another ace. It's a good serve, nicely picked up. Kongyot can't find a winner. Janssens picks that one up. Herbots denied by Pianut. Malika goes deep. Great defensive work again. Van Gestel, clever, really clever. Celine Van Gestel dropped it into midcourt. And everybody's scrambling. And now the Belgians have got some real breathing room. And Coach Danai says, well, we need to call a timeout on this one. But solid defensive work. Janssens there with the rescue. And so clever from Van Gestel. Causing a bit of mayhem on the other side. And a three-point lead now. Well, the hard work in the set has been done by Belgium. They can happily side out from here. As for Thailand, they have got to pick up some points on serve. And time is against them. And that's the last player they want to see serving in a red jersey. Janssens. Nicely taken. And where's that going? Just enough from Chatchorn Moxery. That ball briefly thought about coming back over the net and then said no. Let's keep it exciting. Oof, that's close. That's really close. Really good effort from Dominika Sobolska. Just in vain. Thailand needed that. They now need a point on serve. There could be potentially one here. No, that's a bit of a mess. This is hoist and hope from Chatchorn Moxery. The Belgians can regroup, take the quick set. Thank you very much. Silke van Arnhem, Avermaet says, see you later. The three-point lead remains intact. Nice quick reverse set. Stop that. Van der Viva then will now serve. They fake one way. That's a terrific pickup from Anna Valkenborg, who just has to hoist it here on third touch. And that's too good. Far side as Chanapul Kongyot driving through. Thailand limiting the damage. But they still need a couple of points on their own serve. As it turns into a side-out battle here, and that's going to suit Belgium. The emphasis is on Thailand. Can Tishakorn Boonlert come up with something on serve? It's a good one. Herbots denied. Good block from Malika. Herbots will have another go. The block is there again as Charapon looks for a winner. Can't find it. Van Gestel with the rescue. Grabelna goes cross-court with a winner. Another authoritative swing of that spiking arm from Kaya Grabelna. Belgium stay in control of this first set. Herbots with a biggie. Dealt with authoritatively by the Thais. Plumjit Tinkau off the quick set. Personnel change, sees Gulapa Pyampong Sang come in to pinch it in the server position in the rotation. Very flat serve. It comes over on first touch. Well, Jody Guillaumes will not want to see that one again, the libero for Belgium. It was her overpass that produced that. And an easy put away. And you saw Guillaumes with the despairing dive there, and she's frustrated with herself. Now there's one of those points that they needed, and they went after Guillaumes again. Better from Guillaumes this time. The block is there. Now can they get conjure a spike out of this? Grabelna can. And a duel at the net. Which way is this one going to go? Who wants it? Absolute chaos on the Thai side, and the Belgians can benefit. Kaya Grabelna at the second attempt gets the winning spike. Keeps Belgium in control of their destiny in this first set. Van der Veeva with the cool head, the reverse set, knowing Grabelna is there, near side. The pressure building on both these two teams. Belgium hanging on to a lead, Thailand staying with them, but they still can't draw level. They need this point. Go far side again. That was nice. Onuma Sitirak, one of the experienced veterans off the bench. There's a cool head in a crisis. So still Belgium can't shake the ties off. But can the ties draw level? Malika Kantong is a good source of aces. That's a good one. That's a really good one. That'll do it. That'll level it up. Well, Malika Kantong went after Celine Van Gestel. And Van Gestel struggled with the flight of the ball. And just like that, we're level. Here it goes. Watch this one moving around and then dipping. And Van Gestel just misjudges it. And it only takes a couple of millimeters for the ball to spin off a wrist at a crazy angle. And just like that, a lead is gone. Gert van der Broek absolutely right to call a timeout there. A real no-brainer from a coaching perspective. The entire intensity of this final third of this set has just gone up a couple of notches. Now, have Belgium cracked? Can they regroup? Can they get the next point? Malika Kantong nets. That's a big bonus for the Belgians. Didn't even have to win the point. Remember, you have to win by two clear points. It's not just first to 25. Kaya Grabelna. Pugit denied. A bit of footwork again from her. Is it going to turn into a point? Well, they've still got a chance here. They'll go far side. Brilliant bit of blocking. Still alive somehow. That's four touches. The Belgians back in control. That would have been a highlight reel play if the Tides had won it with all that footwork from Pugit Timkau. We saw it yesterday. Produced a winner for them. Not on this occasion. It was desperation scrambling from Thailand. And now it's Coach Danai just needs to settle everybody back down again. Really creative stuff, but they were scrambling. They were all over the place. All the Belgians had to do was stay cool, stay focused, keep the shape. Well, it was fun while it lasted, that point. More fun if you're a Belgian supporter. So, looks like it's Karapon and the setter, Luxara Tomkom, will come back in. So back to their base rotation for the Thais. But there is no safety net now. For them, they have to take this point and then they have to conjure up something off serve just to get back on terms here. This is a must-win point for them. Mox 3 goes deep where Herbots is picking it up. Herbots on the pipe attack says thank you very much, set point. Well, this was a very nicely constructed point by the Belgians, who have really rallied well after that timeout. And the net from Ashjanapourn Kongyot. And Belgium, finally, in this year's VNL, can celebrate winning the first set. And in the end, they've won it pretty comfortably as well. It was nip and tuck, they had the lead, thought they'd blown it. But then, that timeout was perfectly timed. They got their heads back on and eventually ran away with the first set. This is how it finished. Nice pipe attack set up, and as Charapon finds nothing but net, Belgium say thank you very much. We'll take that one, 25-21. And we're in front. That hasn't happened in nearly a year. So that's how the first set was won. Some very impressive spiking from the Belgians. Grabelder and Herbots leading the way. Lots of variety as well. A slight favouring of the wider positions, of course, but not ignoring the middle either. Their spike placement looking like this. Just shows how good their pipe attacks have been. They've used them sparingly, but very effectively. And Britt Herbots has been very strong in that department as well. She's picked up 5 points, so she's already surpassed the four the Chinese restricted her to yesterday. It's Grabelder leading the way. 6 attack points and an ace serve. And Belgium with the first set in the bank. Second set underway, running attack from Janssens, blocked. They'll go for the pipe attack instead. No block in that. Kaya Grabelder swinging through once again. They are having a lot of success with these straight down the gut attacks. There's another one. Whilst Herbots has been effective, Grabelder showing that she can deliver straight down the pike as well. Oh, that's a mess from her Sharapova. And they're going to be able to clean it up. Malika puts it up in the air. Herbots from the wing this time. And Belgium off to a quick start, carrying on the momentum from the end of that first set. Well, coaches don't like to burn early timeouts, but much more of this. And it wouldn't be a surprise to see the ties call a halt in Janssens. Stays on serve, nets. That's a big break for the Thais, big break. Good serve, really good serve. I think Herbots was waiting to see if that caught any of the net cord. It was so low, just skimmed over there. So that goes down as an ace serve. The Thais needed that. Can Onuma Sitirak find another one? A flat serve goes after Herbots once again. Herbots can go for the decisive touch there. They all think they've got it. It goes Belgium's way. Is it worth a challenge, the Thais are thinking? Maybe not. A libero switch for the Thais. Really good rescue from Valkenborg. Herbots, too good. Sportsmanship there, as Sharapova took a bit of a tumble. It was Britt Herbots over there just making sure. You okay? She's fine. Uh-oh. Here's trouble. Can Sharapova get him out of trouble? No, she can't. Well, very off balance there. It was all off the back of that serve that wreaked such havoc. We're not going to take a look at this. We saw one of the players turn to the coaching staff and say, call it. Did it get anything on the way through? The response, as you saw, was so immediate from the Thais that they clearly saw something. And the way they're looking at each other in that huddle would suggest they're expecting this one to go their way. Well, well, well. They're in for a disappointment. This second set is not working out for them at all. Van de Viva with serve. There's Sharapova on the far side, picked up Van de Viva when he comes over on first touch and put away by Tisha Korn Boonlert. They needed that one. All smiles again. Let's see what young Tisha Korn can come up with here. Goes deep, it's coming back. Picked up by Herberts, who made the first mistake in the first place with the overpass. But now the Belgians can take the authority. As Sharapourne is denied, really good blocking. As Sharapourne again, not stopping that. That's one of those points both teams will look at and say, hey, we had control of that point. And it's the Thais who end up on top. Should have made it a lot easier after the poor service reception from the Belgians, but they got there in the end. Still looking to level it up here. Herberts. Like a greyhound coming out of the trap, that one for Britt Herberts. She saw it very early and said, I'm making my move, look at this. Swing, bang, gone. Herberts again with that high ball toss of hers. As Chatterporn blocked out of it. Great blocking work there. Well, a double block in place, and it was Herberts leading the cheers. Not sure whether she got the touch or not. Doesn't really matter, as long as somebody gets it. Was it Grabelda getting that? Chalk it up to Kaya Grabelda. That's a really nice take. So close to an outstanding dig backcourt from Britt Herberts. That really would have been miraculous. Close as well. The Plumjit will take the winner. Now the Thais still chasing here. As we close in on the first technical timeout. Oh, that is really good. That was one of those awkward ones that come back at you, but Kaya Grabelda angled that one perfectly. It takes Belgium to the technical timeout in control still. Grabelda moves to double figures. Silke van Avermaet then will serve, with Belgium a set to the good and starting the second set strongly as well. There's trouble, Malika can't find a winner from there. Far side, no stopping Kaya Grabelda at the moment. Red hot. That's another real swing of authority. And the Thais really chasing. Just trying to hang on here at the moment. And Avermaet will stay with serve. The running attack, too good from Plumjit this time, bisecting the two backcourt defenders. But they're just hanging on here, the Thais. Chachu Onmokhsri will serve. Pretty quiet for her so far. Van Gestel can't find a winner. Nice reverse set. Plumjit drops it into space. Where's this going to go? Third touch, it goes back over. The Thais will have to remount another challenge. Malika just has to improvise. Now can the Belgians set up Grabelda? Yes, they can, but it's a pickup from Nutsara. Backcourt it goes. Chachu Onmokhsri denied by Guillaumes. Pipe attack. Catches a net cord. And then Malika goes deep. Guillaume's absolutely brilliant, but the call has been made in the chair. the Belgians, with that rear guard action, tease the attack hit fault. Coach Danai says, we've got to do something about this. That was a really good rear guard the Belgians mounted there. A couple of important digs from Jody Guillaumes. There's one of them right there. Well, we saw against Korea, although the Belgians lost in straight sets, they got better the longer that match went on. We certainly saw that in the first round of matches in Bulgaria. Obviously, China was a different story, but you'd expect that against the Chinese. The worry for Thailand is that the Belgians are actually going to build up a head of steam here the longer this goes on. And, that's on Numa Sitarak, unable to find a winner, but will they get another bite? Yes, they will. And this time, Pumjit says, that's my shot, give it to me, and I'll take it. Here she goes again, running attack. She put that where there were some bodies waiting, but the quality of the spike, just too good. I think Britt Herbertz is thinking, I could have had that, but for the dive from the libero in front of her. Pumjit now will serve. There's another running attack. Marlies Janssens, the tie's on the receiving end of it this time. It was set up all the way, everybody could see what was coming. Seeing it is one thing, defending it is another when it's executed that well. Celine Van Gestel. Clever serve and an even cleverer second touch from Nutsara Tomkom. That's your shock weapon. You can't overuse it. When you do use it, you've got to make sure nobody's expecting it. Like that. Little touch there. Not enough to provide a winner. Great backcourt work again from Herbots, but it's going to come back again. Van Gestel with an outrageous dig. And then nothing doing there for Grabelna. Guillaumes now keeps it alive. What a rally. This is Herbots. Can't find a winner either. They'll take it far side. Brilliant backcourt work again from Grabelna. This is stunning stuff. It really is. This is it. Herbots. Oh, a big swing and a big miss. That was surely a bit of fatigue because that was a long, draining rally. But if you had to pick a banker on the Belgian side, Britt Herbertz would have been high on your list. They set her up, and she just overhit it. And another terrific rally, both teams serving up a treat here. Nutsara will serve at 9-11. There's the running attack. Marlies Janssens. It's not particularly pretty, but it's effective. Slipping it round there, scrubbing it off the block of Aluma Sitirak. That's all it needs. You don't get bonus points for style and flair. Now Janssens will be looking for an ace or two. Not getting one there. But they may get a decent chance at this one. They'll send it to Britt Herbots. And Herbots, once again, trying to evade the block. Just shunts it out of play. Sitirak with the floater. Van Gestel watched it all the way. The pipe attack from Kaya Grabelna misses, of all people. But they've just gone a bit cold here, the Belgians. That's three misses in a row. Two from Herbots, one from Grabelna. And they're their best, most consistent hitters as well. And Gestel handles that one. Herberts gets it right this time to keep Belgian noses in front. Here's the captain, Ilke van de Viva. The block is good. They'll go far side. The block is good again, but it just drops out of bounds. Belgium. So close there. You know, the call in the chair was overturned as well. The original call was Thailand's ball, but that, well, you can see from the Thais' reaction, yeah, that did drop in. Time it comes back like that, it's meat and drink to Amporn Hiafa off the bench, clogging up the middle. Now at full stretch there, van de Viva, that eventually got what it deserved. Still playing the chasing game here, Thailand, as Hiafa, another one of these veterans, 34 years old, sends in the serve. Nothing doing there. They'll take it far side. Moxrey denied. Van Gestel there with the defensive work, and they just watched it, saw where that was going to go. Left it alone. And the Thais edge a little bit closer. Too close for Gert van der Broek. He wants to talk this one over. So after the timeout, Hiafa will continue with serve as the Thais look to level up this set. And they'll do it right there. The ace serve, they went after Jody Guillaume's to good effect. Just like that, they are level. So that timeout didn't work out. Hiafa again, going for Guillaume's again. That's not ideal, but just falls nicely for them. But the Thais with another chance here. Moxrey denied. Guillaume's keeps it alive. They'll send it far side of Grabelna, blocked out of it. Plume Jit and Malika Gantong were there together. No way through for Kaya Grabelna, and the Belgians are right off the boil here. That's an important pickup from Sitirak, and then the block is there. Sent back with interest. And Hiafa will continue with serve. Guillaume's again has struggled badly. Grabelna tries to conjure something up, but the initiative is with the Thais, and the Thais take the lead as we get to the second technical timeout, and that is quite a turnaround. And this technical timeout has come at the wrong time for the Thais, but at absolutely the right time for Belgium, because they're in disarray at the moment. Britt Herberts has rediscovered her form after being shut out by the Great Wall of China yesterday into double digits. Has done a lot of good work defensively, but she's also had a couple of misses earlier in this set that has helped Thailand seize the initiative back here again. So it's a bit of a mixed report card on Britt Herbert's. Yes, she's back in business, but a little bit more consistency from the hitting might be needed here. And the Belgian three-point lead has turned into a two-point deficit. Now, can they get back on track here? Herbert's, yeah, nobody home for the ties. That's more like it from Britt Herbert's going cross-court. And nobody was stopping that. Does love to serve, doesn't she? Really puts everything into it. And talk about putting everything into it. What about that? From Chet Chu on box three. All about technique. Herbert's has done a really good job defensively in the backcourt, patrolling the baseline, but she couldn't get that. It was too good. Malika Kantong will now serve. Very capable server. Oh, my goodness. Got away with one there, but how long for? Yeah, that was dealt with. Got what it deserved. Kayaka Rapelna overdue a point. So she's back in business. Belgium looked to have pulled themselves out of that mini slump. Now Silke van Avermaet will now serve, looking to level it up. Chachu on Moxtree, denied by the block. Lujic, clever again. Yeah, floor touch confirmed in the chair. Well, Plumjit is not all about power. Anybody who's ever seen her play knows that, but she's clever. She's sneaky and creative. You never quite know what's going to come from her. Drop that into space perfectly. Ties staying in control of the set here as Moxtree serves. Van Gestel handles, they'll send it far side and blocked out of it. Plumjit taking out Grabelna there. That's a big point. So important that Grabelna had to win this one. Not much wrong with it, but Kaya Grabelna denied by Plumjit, who gambled and came up with a winner. Where's that going? Herbert's. That's where it was going. Amanda Weaver knew exactly what she was doing with that set. Britt Herbert's steaming through to keep the Belgians close, but they're still chasing. That's an ace serve just when it was needed from Grabelna. That cuts the deficit in half. As simple as that. Second ace from the serve of Kaya Grabelna. Can she find another one here to level it up? Got a bunch of net there. Plumjit has to find a winner there and scrubs it off the block. Side out Thailand. Plumjit in double figures for the game. Spare a thought for Celine Van Gestel. They did everything she could defensively. Plumjit serve aimed at Herbert's. That's a nice outside hit there from Marlies Janssens. Keeps the Belgians in the slipstream of their opponents. Side out. Van Gestel looking to tie it up. Nice serve. Chachuan Moxtree's handled it really brilliantly. Think about this, Satirak. She finds Valkenburg, the libero. Herbert's looks to level it up, can't do it. Yes, she can. Pianut Panoy would love to have that one back, the Thai libero. But the power from Britt Herbert's just too much for the backcourt libero. And the Belgians back in business. Well, both teams have had a lead and blown it in this second set. Nothing anybody could do with the angle that Anuma Sitirak took there. She's in with Azcharapourn Kongyot taking a breather on the sideline, and she is certainly making the most of this cameo on Uma Sitirak. So who's going to make the break for the finish line here. Herbots. That's not coming back. That was never coming back. Britt Herbots surpasses Kaya Grobelda with that spike as the game's top scorer, 14 points. Janssens. Now, we've been waiting for one of those. Marlies Janssens, good for a couple of aces per game. That's her first of this one. And right now, Coach Danai Sriwacharyattakul realizes he has got to call a halt here because the momentum, which has shifted more than once in this set, has switched again, and it's against his side. Well, the Tigers need a response off the back of that timeout. If they lose the next point, and it's the Janssens they're facing, remember, this set may well just have gone. This is a must-win point for the Tigers. Can Janssens conjure up another dazzling serve? She can. It's an ace straight at Chachu on Mox 3, and that might be the moment that blows this set wide open. Back-to-back aces from Marlies Janssens. And Thailand forced to get Moxery out of the firing line as Chatterpaul comes back in. But is it too late? Janssens, five aces against China yesterday. Back-to-back aces here. And a really nice pickup there from Van Gestel. Grabelna misses. My goodness me, that was effectively the set right there, and Kaya Grabelna has just pushed it too deep. The Tigers have a bit of hope, and what a chance that was for Grabelna to virtually shut the door on this second set. They are still in control of this, though. Thailand need to win this point, but they're not going to. That was as easy as you like. Silkevan Avermaet slipping around the backside for set point. It's Ilka van der Viva, the setter, the captain, who will serve for a two-set Belgian lead here. As Chatterpaul didn't find a winner. She's come up with a block instead, but still the Belgians can recycle this. Oh, my goodness, what about that? What a finish. Celine van Gestel, absolutely brilliant in the backcourt, and Kaya Grabelna finishing with a flourish as well. Well, that's a point the Tigers thought they'd won twice. What a pancake that was from Van Gestel. What a kill from Grabelna. And it's a two-set Belgium lead. Two close sets. And at the business end of both of them, it's the Belgians that have held their nerve. And the Tigers now in deep trouble. Now Belgium, who hadn't won a set in Macau, and now won two in a row. One more will give them their first victory of this round of pool matches. So that's how the second set was won and lost. The Belgians, who had the lead, lost it, let it slip. And then the ties let it slip when it really mattered. Despite the smiles in the crowd, the ties in a world of trouble here. There were high hopes of achieving their third victory of the VNL campaign right here, right now. Well, to do that, they're going to have to come from a long way back. But nothing will ever stop him supporting his nation proudly. Well, are we going to get our first five setter in Macau? Thailand at least take it into a fourth set, or can Belgium wrap it up in three? We're about to find out. And remember, the Belgians seem to get stronger the longer a match goes on. Thailand against China faded badly, as Belgium, even though both teams lost against the Chinese in straight sets, they got better the longer it went on against China. Well, they're not getting better there. The big news for Thailand is that's Marlies Janssens out of the service rotation immediately. That's a huge bonus for them. It'll be interesting to see what Coach Danai does with his personnel. There have been some ups and downs on the Thai side, as Charapon, Chachuan Moxri are both had fits and starts. Both teams with a shaky start in this third set. A net serve is matched by a long serve from Plugit on the Thai side, which will bring up Ilka van der Viva next for the Belgians. And that's going to go as well. Well, the big three of Malika, as Charapon and Chachuan Moxri. Piled on the points against Korea, being very much held in check here. 14 points between the three of them through two sets. Grabelna, who has 14 points on her own, denied there. Good block coming in from the Belgians there. And another one. That's Silke van Avermaet right in the heart of it all. Chachuan Moxri denied. Van Gestel couldn't keep it in play, though. Again, really strong backcourt scurrying from Celine van Gestel, but in vain. And the Thais make the early move here. Canton sends a long one in. Herbots with the jumper. Chachuan Moxri, too good. Backcourt. Herbots and Valkenburg collide, but thankfully no damage. Do see nasty injuries where players come together like that. Thankfully, no damage done there. Now, the personnel shuffling continues with Wanit Chaya Luangtong Lang coming into play here for Thailand. There's another one of the subs, Onuma Sitirak, who's been on for a while, going nice with the cross court. Well, he certainly shuffled his pack, Coach Danai, when you look at the likes of Sitirak and Hiafa, and now Luangtong Luang out there as well. He's not just sticking to his starting six. He's going to the bench as that one nets. Bid to find the right blend. Moxri with the net serve. Thailand didn't need that, but they do need to win this set. Picked up by Canton. send it near side, and near side is effective for Kaja Grabelna. That's the little deft finesse play for the Belgians. They were looking to wipe out that deficit right here. Van Avermaet. Good serve, ace serve from Silke van Avermaet. That's a really strong response from the Belgians to falling behind early, leveling it up very, very quickly. And Chatuan Muxeri is victimized again. Wonder if Coach Danai might yank him out of the firing line, get her to recharge. Meanwhile, the other number 19 serves wide this time. A lot of variety and creativity in the Silke van Avermaet serve. Nothing safe about it. Again, the ties push on from here. Ampon Hiafa serves Van Gestel. Van Gestel can come back up the other way. Can't find a winner. Sitirak. Nice pickup back court from Herberts. Grabelna too strong yet again. She's been a constant problem for the Thais throughout this match. Grabelna, here she is again. Worth pointing out that Britt Herberts has also chipped in with 14 points and a ton of digs in the backcourt as well. Grabelna with serve. That's good enough. Marlies Janssens. Well, they got the one blocker that they wanted as Janssens took flight. That's all it needed. Grabelna, should I say, excuse me, with serve. Sitirak blocked out of it. Sitirak will have another go. Grabelna is there. Herberts is there. So too is Pianut. And there, importantly for Thailand, Plumjit Tinkau with a swing and just enough contact to take it away from the block. Well, that's an important pickup. And then just enough from Plumjit. Just enough is good enough. Nutsara with serve, and Gestel goes cross court where Supatra was there. And Sitirak denied by another effort from Herberts. This one's getting reviewed. Was there a floor touch? Surely it's going to be the call, because that looked miraculous from Herberts. You've got to be pretty confident to call that one. Well, while we wait for confirmation. Ooh. Hello. Is there anything there? No, there is not. Well, well, well. A blown call by the Thais. Great rescue. So it's the Belgians who get the point off that blown call. It's a strange call from the Thais then. You've got to be absolutely 100% sure of a call like that, otherwise you lose the point. have to do something special to keep that fella quiet. And he's not had much to shout about, but his team needs him right now. As Celine Van Gestel serves off the back of the technical timeout, 8-7 Belgium. And an ace is dropped in, right on the line for Van Gestel. Notable for some stellar defensive work in this match, Celine Van Gestel, and that absolutely perfect. Dropped inside the line pretty comfortably in the end. Had to try and slide it down the line there, couldn't find anything. Not much of a play available here for Grabella other than dump and hope. Yeah, once that dump and hope goes over, all the initiative passes to the receiving team, and Malika Tang Kantong says, right, let's go. The ties really do need to get going. They played well in fits and starts, but the Belgians overall have had that extra gear of consistency that's got them over the line in the first two sets, as Onuma Sitirak continues with this lengthy workout that she's getting in this match. Serving Guillaumes, and then Grabelna with the pipe attack. Picked off, Chatsu on Moxri, too good. Oh, some frustration in the backcourt there. Oh, the hard-working Grabelna would love to have another bite at that. And a deceptively powerful hitter, Chatsu on Moxri. Look at the movement on that ball as well, just spinning off the attempted dig. So close. Sitirak continuing with serve. Britt Herbots continuing the smashdown winners. The 15th attack point of this match. Janssens looks for another ace. Didn't miss by all that much. Bloomjit Tinkau with serve. Van Gestel, not the best service reception. Herbots with a lot of work to do from there. The initiative swings over to the ties, but they can't find a winner. And in the end, a big swing from Grabelna. That was tough to come drop a winner out of there, and Grabelna decided not to play safe and contain. Go for the winner. It was always a very low percentage attempt from there, though. Worth having a go, and an indication of the Belgian confidence that they feel, particularly Grabelna and Herbots, who are swinging so well. Not that time. Tinkau continues. Herbots, now that has been picked up. And Ochatsu on Moxri had to get that and doesn't. That's a big miss. Setter Van de Viva. And the call goes against the Belgians. Oh, yeah. Penetration there. Oh, that took off. Got a little bit too much air under that one, and I think it caught a thermal on the way through. So we stay level. Herbots, an ace long overdue. Not going to get it there either. Nice pickup. Running attack doesn't work from Hiafa. Grabelna absolutely on the money again. Sent it deep. Dropped it perfectly. Kaya Grabelna at her best. A really nice setup as well from her hitting partner, Britt Herbots, from the baseline as well. That was brilliant. Well, still she can't find an ace. It's amazing how well she's serving. The Thais are defending it so well, and Chanchorn Moxrey gets back to her best with a neat finish. It stays level here, this third set. The Belgians looking to wrap it up in three. The Thais looking to drag it into a fourth. Really nice pickup there from Gulapa, but the Belgians will get a second go at this. They'll send it near side. Grabelna denied the block, doing just enough. And Sitirak, oh, having been set up, she had a difficult angle to work with, very hard angle, but will be disappointed with the finish. Is that missed by quite a margin? So can the Belgians make a little move here? Van Avermaet drops one in. Second touch doesn't work. Chatsuan Moxrey cleans up the mess very efficiently indeed. Well, that could have backfired badly on the Thais, but Chatsuan Moxrey had one aim in mind there. Tough to hit winners. From that kind of distance, when the ball is ping-ponging around like that as well. There must be a strong wind blowing from right to left in that building, the way the Thais are catching these long serves at the moment. Somebody left a door open somewhere? Grabelna. A running attack, good enough from Doomjit. We stay level. Up comes as Charapon Kongyot. Batteries recharged. It's Malika Kantong taking a breather this time. His big three getting rotated by Coach Danai in this match. Britt Herberts catching the line. We get to the second technical timeout. This third set up for grabs. Well, Herberts, it says it all that she went into the China game averaging 17 points per match. The Chinese and that defensive wall of theirs restricting her to 4 points here. Back up to 16. Plenty of time to at least match the 17 that she was averaging going into time. The China game, that really does give an indication of just how formidable the Chinese are defensively. Well, Chatsuan Moxrey has been the go-to player of the big three, the gang of three for the Thais, with Malika and Ash Charapon pretty much neutralized. Now, if the Thais can give her a little bit of help on the offensive side of things, still time for them to turn this one around. Right now they've got to hang on here as Celine Van Gestel serves at 16-15. Yeah, nice. Doomjit moves on to 15 points. She's had quite a match here. Very efficient. Not a lot of frills about Doomjit Tinkau. Just gets on with the job. Sitirak with serve. Talking about getting on with the job, there's another middle blocker that doesn't waste much effort or energy, just gets on with the job with a high level of efficiency. Marlies Janssens again, and Janssens, as we know, a very dangerous server. So this is a critical moment in this match with the Belgians up by a point and Janssens serving. They've got to deal with this Thailand, and they do. That was a big, big point. Get Janssens out of there. Keep it level. Keep this third set up for grabs. Keep the match alive. That could be a hugely significant point. Doomjit now will serve. No, she won't. She will net. You can see she was trying to be a sneaky server there. Ilka van de Viva. Chachu drops it in perfectly. Clever. Great court awareness there from the youngster. And we stay level. These are very nervous moments for the Thais in particular. One misfire and the whole match could be gone. If a gap opens up here at this late stage of the third set and you're chasing, you're probably not going to get it back. As Chatterpaw with an ace! Floated in there. Celine van Gestel had so long to look at it. Almost had too long. Doesn't seem to get caught in two minds off the service reception as Chatterpaw just hung one out there. Now, will she try the same again, or will she mix things up a little bit? This is another big moment in the match as well. Now, Chatterpaw tries the floater again on Van Gestel, who handles it much better, and it's put away. Van de Viva. Situation, substitution, sees Herbots come out, and Manon Stragier come in. We've seen this in the past with the Belgians. That they will drop Stragier into the server rotate the position in the rotation when they think they need something. Well, what they've got there is a good serve, and the initiative passes, and Van Gestel says thank you very much off the back end. That was a terrific move from Gert van der Broek to drop Stragier in like that. It's caused Thailand to take a second timeout. The overpass punished. All three sets have been highly competitive, but in the first two sets, when we got to this point, the Belgians pulled away. Found another gear. Is it going to be three in a row for them? Can Thailand just hang on here? Stragier will continue to serve. It's a bit of a mess, but the Thais may get a second bite at this with Roots. Oh, Chatsuan Moxeri misses. That could be the miss that cost Thailand the match. They're going to call it. They have to call it, Thailand. Get this looked at. Hope for the best. Maybe. Maybe it took a touch on the way through. In fact, it's just been called anyway. I think the referees have said, yeah, we don't need to look at that. That was a touch. And there's no argument from Belgium either. Big, big moment there. So we stay level. Chatsuan Moxeri with serve. Nerves jangling everywhere right now. Van Gestel can't come up with a winner. Sitirak can't come up with a winner either, but she's done enough. Done enough. Van Gestel tried to keep it alive. Van de Viva's second touch went nowhere. Now Thailand getting their noses back in front. So frustrating for everybody when it just drops in space like that. Look at that. Six players on court, nobody anywhere near it. And now Gert van der Broek has to call timeout. What would it do to the Belgians if they were to lose from here? When they were so close. Another change in fortunes. Don't be surprised if those other two timeouts don't get burned here. High stakes now. If it comes down to cheerleading, Thailand won't be stopped, will they? The Belgians have got to just drown out that background noise. Focus, side out. Oh, a skimmer. Grabelna denied by Azcharapong. Sitirak just has to dump one in though. Van der Veeven with options, goes back court, and the huge stuff from Anpor Niafa wiped out Britt Herbert's one-on-one. A massive point for the Thais. That right there could take this into a fourth set and keep Thailand alive in the match. What a moment. Well, the Belgians will just have to shove this over and hope for the best. They're in real trouble here. They're still alive. Nothing more than a push and hope, though. Thailand at the third attempt. Can they find the winner? No, they can't. Van Gestel diving around here, there and everywhere. And then Grabelna scrubs one off the block. And Belgium win a point they had no business being in. That was a full rearguard action. And the Thais blew a couple of good chances there to kill that point. This is so important. Great defensive work. Absolutely brilliant. Well, they've earned the right to have a go at this. And in the end, Grabelna, who's been pretty quiet recently, comes up big time for them. Now then, can they level it up? Sitirak, no winner there. Van der Veeven picks that up. Grabelna denied by Azcharapong. Huge dig from her. Sitirak. No good again. Van Gestel picks it up. Herbots. Belgium back in business. Big response from them. Sure enough, there goes another timeout. Herbots came through on that one like an express train. They had it won, surely. Now, they're back in the dogfight here in this third set. What a good match this has been. Are we enjoying the last few moments of it? Can Thailand hang on here, take it to a fourth? I think all the neutrals in the arena just want this to go on and on. It's been really good stuff. Belgium so close to the win, but not over the line yet. That's going to travel on Silke van Avermaet. Somebody opened the door at the other end of the building. Side out. And Paul Hiafa, who had that monster block earlier, comes up with the serve. That's going to go as well. There's a lot of nails getting chewed around the Macau Forum at the moment. 23 all, third set. Grabelna with serve. Sitirak blocked out of it, picked up by Nutsara. Sitirak will have another go, drops it into space. Grabelna picks it up. Van Gestel grows cross court, can't find a winner. Chatjuan Moxeri, not much to play with there. Van Gestel gets a second bite and gets the winner. Match point, Belgium. Oh, this was a slow burner of a point. Another long, draining rally. Not much work for Chatjuan Moxeri to do there. She put it as good as anywhere. And Grabelna, who had that dig, can serve for the match, and it's an ace to win it. Kaya Grabelna comes up with the big play when it mattered. And Belgium, who were battered against China, who succumbed against Korea, will finish with a flourish in the Macau Forum, putting Thailand to the sword in straight sets. That's a big win for this young squad. Just look what it means to them. Grabelna's 19th point of the match was the most important. an ace serve. And Thailand, who had that third set where they wanted it, let it slip away. Disappointment for them, but you always want to finish on a high. And that was the highest of highs for Belgium. Kaya Grabelna with 19 points on the night. Sitirak on the far side drops her head. Just lost it. And the Belgian celebrations are only just beginning. Well, they never really got going against Korea. China, of course, were way too strong. But that was an impressive response from the Belgians. It's their third win in the VNL this year. Last year, all season, they managed four. They've got every chance of improving on that tally. And for Thailand, real disappointment. This was a match that they felt going in, they had a chance at winning instead. They've been shut out in straight sets, and here's how.